welcome to this first video in a series of videos that I want to make to try to explain a little bit all the different options that there is in the home chart for deploying Datadog on a Kubernetes cluster. When people start deploying Datadog on their cluster using the Helm chart, they are sometimes overwhelmed with the amount of different features and different options that there are. So the goal of this first one and the series of videos I'm going to make is to explain some of these options so you can decide what is best to monitor your Kubernetes cluster. Important to say, these videos are not about best practices on how you should monitor Kubernetes using Datadog. If you're interested in learning how to do that, I recommend you to go to learn.datadoghq.com, which basically has a workshop on exactly that topic, on best practices on how you should monitor your Kubernetes cluster using Datadog. So again, the goal of this video, first video in the series of videos, is to show all the different options on the Helm chart and how to use them. The goal, this first video is going to be about the most basic options that you need to get you started. And on future videos, what we are going to cover is more specific advanced features that the Datadog agent has for Kubernetes clusters, so you can decide what's best for your specific use case. For everything that we are going to do on this video, I want you to be able to try those options without having to have your own Kubernetes cluster or having to use your company's Kubernetes cluster. So I have created a category scenario that I'm going to be doing throughout this video, and there is a link on the description on this video to that same scenario. So after the video, please, if you want to give it a try, go there and use that to try this out. So let's try this. Let's move myself a little bit away from here. Okay, so this is the Katakoda scenario, as you will see it if you're trying this yourself. So the good thing about this is that as soon as you come here, it's completely free. You already have your Kubernetes cluster. So let's have a look on how it looks like. So we have two nodes on our cluster. So we have a control plane node and a worker node. And those are already ready to go when you start using Katakoda. Obviously, the first thing that we will need to do is to connect the agent to our Datadog account. To use that, we are going to expose the API key from your Datadog account in a variable here. I've already done this off camera, so you don't see my API key, but these are instructions to do it yourself. So what are the things that we have here? So we have here an editor with the different values that we are going to be using for this video for Helm, with different options. We will see that in a second. But the first thing that we are going to do is to deploy the Datadog agent in this Kubernetes cluster using the default options. So the default options, the values.yaml, the counts by default, if you don't change anything. And let's see what happens. So basically what we are saying here is to Helm install a Datadog release using the API key that we had exposed, and with the default values.yaml without changing anything. So let's see, let's put this a little bit bigger here. So let's see what this creates. When we just use the default values, there is a lot of things going on. So first thing is that there are several secrets that got created. So we have the most important one is the Datadog secret, which basically has your API key encoded in base 64, like any secret in Kubernetes. And then we have several token secrets those are the secrets that are created for the service accounts that got created for both Datadog Agent and KubeState Metrics to connect to the Kubernetes API. Good, so that's great. We have created some service accounts, we have created some secrets. What about the workloads? What are the workloads that we have created? So first thing that we can see here is that we have created a deployment. We have created a KubeState Metrics deployment by default. What's the goal? So KubeState Metrics, it's an open source project, it's part of the CNCF, it's part of the Kubernetes organization, that the goal is to gather a lot of metrics from the Kubernetes API. So it's going to be watching and poking the Kubernetes API for new data about pods being running or pods being pending, etc., etc. And it's going to expose all that information as metrics. And Datadog is relying a lot on that fantastic project to Kubernetes monitoring, and that's why the Helm chart creates that deployment by default. That said, if you have your own deployment for Kubernetes state metrics, you're able to remove that from happening on one of the options. Okay, what about the agent? We have a daemon set with the default options of the Helm chart. We deploy also a daemon set, which is the Datadog agent. A daemon set is a special Kubernetes deployment that ensures that you have at least one replica on every node of your cluster. Why do we want an agent on every node? Because basically every agent on that particular node is going to gather information from the kubelet from that node and expose that to Datadog. So we need one of these worker nodes, node agents, in every worker node. So if it's a daemon set, let's get the pods that we have created and what nodes are they deployed to. So if you do this, you will see that we only have one pod. Remember that the cluster that we have now has two nodes, a control plane and a worker node. So you may think that if we are deploying a daemon set, that agent pod is going to be deployed on both nodes, but it got only deployed to the worker node. Why is that? The reason of that is because our control plane node has attained. So it has, let's go up a little bit here. So it has attained that basically says only pods that have a corresponding toleration are able to be deployed on this node. The goal of these taints in general is that all your workloads won't be added to your control plane nodes, and only the important, the control plane pods are going to be deployed to the control plane node. That said, if you're running your own control plane nodes, you may, obviously you want to run a Datadog agent on those to be able to monitor also your control plane nodes. So basically, we will do that using a toleration on our next step. But before that, let's check the Datadog status, Datadog agent status. So if we do this, this agent command, by the way, all those commands are on the Katakura scenario. You just click on them and they run. So it's fairly easy. So we have some checks here running. We have a kubelet one that is erroring out. We are going to fix it in a future step explaining another option from the Helm chart. So yeah, this way we can have all the information about the agent. Okay, let's continue. The first thing that we are going to do on the next step is to add tolerations to the Datadog Agent Pods. So they run also on the control plane node. The good news is that this is super easy to do with the Helm chart, because there is exactly one section on the values.yaml to add tolerations to your pod. So it's fairly easy. So what we're going to do is to edit the values.yaml, and on that section specific for tolerations, we are going to do we're going to mimic the same taint that had our control plane node, so the same key and effect, to make sure we are able to deploy that on our control plane node. To make things easier, if you want to run this categorized scenario, we already have a values.yaml file with this change. It's called values/toleration. So if you run this div command here, you can see that the only difference between the previous values.yaml, the full values.yaml, and the one that we are going to apply is that section. We have added that toleration. So let's upgrade our Helm deployment, Helm release, to add that. So basically we are upgrading our Helm release, but using these new values/tolerations with a new value. Cool. So let's see if this works. Let's check the number of pods that we have now. So if we run the same command that we run to get the pods from Datadog, now we have two different pods, the control plane one, the node 011. So that's great, that worked. Let's continue to the next thing that we are going to do. So remember that when we were running the aging status, the kubelet check didn't work. The reason why it didn't work is we don't have the right certs to connect to it. So what we are going to do, and because this is not a production environment, what we are going to do is to tell the agent to skip TLS verification. So how do you do that in the Datadog agent? Is you do that through an environment variable that you set. So what we need to do is an option in our Helm chart to add n variables for that Datadog agent. Again, this is super easy to do because exactly there is a section here for setting up n variables that affect every deployment in our Helm chart. So what we are going to do is to modify that one, and we are going to add the kubelet TLS verify options to false to make sure we skip that. Again, to make things a little bit easier, we already have one values.yaml that builds on top of the one that we use on the previous step that just have that difference. So you can see if you run this div, the only difference between the values-tolerations YAML that we just applied to this new one that we are going to apply is that we've changed the env section to add that particular environment variable. So again, same thing, let's apply this change, and it's been upgraded. And you actually, if you run the pods, you will see that they will restart. It was fairly straightforward, so they're just restarting, which is great. They are not yet ready, so let's wait a little bit until they are. Let's see what nodes are they running in. So the one for the node 01 is already ready, up and running. So let's run that one, the status for that one, and let's check whether the kubelet check was fixed. And it was fixed. So that's great. So we know now two options for our helm chart. So we know how to add tolerations to our pod, very important, especially if you're running your own control plane node, because those usually get some taints, and also how to add environment variables to our pods, which can help in many, many ways. Good, so let's move on to the next step. The next thing that we are going to do is to enable logs. So right now we only have metrics and process information for the full helm values. Actually, if you run again the agent status, you can see here logs agent is not running. So if you're using log collection in Datadog, obviously you want to start getting the logs from your containers. So how do we do that? Again, there is a section on the Helm chart to do just so. So there is a section in the values.yaml about log collection. It's not enabled by default. And so basically enable is false, and container collect all is also false. Container collect all is an option to collect all the logs from all the containers running in your Kubernetes cluster, and obviously we want to do that. So we are going to set both to true and see if that enables logging. So again, we have prepared a values-logs .yaml file that builds on top of the kubelet one. So we are building on top of the previous one all the time. And if you diff those two differences, you can see that the only difference is that logs are enabled to true, are chained to true, container collect all is also true. So those are the only two differences. So let's clear this up. And we are going to, again, upgrade our Datadog release, Helm release, with this new values-logs YAML file. So it's going to start rerunning the pods. So as you can see, the first pod is already restarted. So it waits until at least one of them is up and running to continue. So by default, the Helm chart do rolling updates. Let's see which pod, which one is more up and running. So it's going to be node 01, the first one that is going to be ready. Let's wait until all the readiness checks are good. Still not there. Yeah, it is there, sorry, change the order. So the node one, it's ready. So let's do that. So if we, again, the agent status command is super useful to understand what's going on your Datadog agent, how it's behaving. You can see that now logs agent is enabled. You can see the logs that are already being sent to my Datadog account. And because we decided to add all the containers, so it says all the different pods that are running on our cluster, sending logs to the Datadog. So that's great. So building up, we already know how to add tolerations to our pods, how to add environment variables to our pods, and how to enable logs. So let's do another enabling one of the agents again. So we are going to do tracing as well. We want to enable distributed tracing APM for our applications running in our cluster. But if you again run the agent status command, you can see that the APM agent doesn't run by default. So again, if we want to enable distributed tracing APM, we need to enable that agent. So again, the way to do that in the Helm chart is a lot easier than, for example, using the YAML definitions directly, because you have all these sections that help you find the right option to change. So again, there is an option, there is a section about APN at the very top of the options. You can see that it's enabled, it's false. And also use socket volume is false as well. We are going to change that to true. So we are going to enable APN, but also we are going to, instead of using UDP for communication with the agent, we are going to use basically a unisocket. So again, we have ready a values dash APM YAML ready file with that section on. And if we do a diff between the logs one and this one, you can see that the only difference is that APM now it's true, enable true, and use exact volume is true as well. So same thing, let's upgrade our HEM release. This is now the revision number 5. And let's wait until all the pods are up and running. Seems like Node 01 again is going to be the first one that is going to be with the new version, with the new options. Again, rolling updates on our daemon set by default if you don't change anything on your Helm chart related to release strategies. And let's wait a little bit more. Yeah, seems to be ready now. So if now we run again the agent status, we have now the APM agent up and running. So we are ready to start instrumenting our applications and sending traces back to that talk. And the last thing that we are going to see today for the basic options, again, this is the first video in a series of videos that I'm going to create. And the rest of the videos is going to focus on more specific advanced features of the Helm chart. This one about basic things like APM, logs. The last one is about the cluster agent. So aside from the node agent that is running as a daemon set on every node in our cluster, there is another option there is another type of agent called the cluster agent that doesn't run as a daemon set. It's this one here. It runs as a normal deployment with one or more replicas. And the goal of that one is to gather all the information about the API server. So the Datadog node agents that have to be poking the API server all the time for information. This is important to use, especially as soon as you have many nodes on your cluster. So as you horizontally scale your cluster, it's really recommended to also deploy the cluster agent. But again, this is not by default. So if you deploy the Helm chart as it is, it won't deploy the cluster agent. But again, there is an option to do so that is easy to find. You can see here this option on the values.yaml. It says cluster agent enable false. And also it has many options. One of the options is the number of replicas that you want to deploy. If you have a small cluster, probably one should be enough. As soon as you get bigger, probably you want to add one more or more. And again, we have a values cluster agent.yaml file ready for you to try, so you don't have to edit things manually. You're able to do so if you want to play around as well. If you diff between the previous one and the current one, the only thing that we change is that cluster agent enabled true. We didn't change the number of replicas, so it's going to get one replica by default. We didn't change any of the options, we just did that. So let's upgrade our Datadog Helm release and let's see what happens now. So again, if you get the number of secrets, we have new secrets now. So most important one is the Datadog cluster agent that is going to be the one that we are going to be using to talk to the node agent. So they have to have a token that it's automatically generated in order to securely communicate between all the node agents and the cluster agents. What about deployment? So remember, we had the Kubestate metrics that was by default with the Helm chart, and now we have a second one. We have the DataDog cluster agent with one replica, which is the part of the cluster agent. So let's check now that both of our node agents are successfully connected to the cluster agent. So if you run the agent status here from one of the first nodes, you can see that the node agent is successfully connected to the cluster agent using that token that was automatically generated. That was for node 01. Let's check the second one. And same thing, it's connected to the cluster agent. Finally, if you want to check the part that it's the cluster agent itself, you can click on this one, and it's going to get the status of the cluster agent, not any of the node agents. And you can see the difference here, because the only check that is running is the one for the Kubernetes API server. So it's not running any of the node specific checks. Good, so that's it for today. We have seen some of the basic options that you have for your Helm chart. And again, I'm going to do a second one with a specific, not a second one, but a series of ones, also connected to a categorized scenario to help you try all these options with more advanced options. So thanks again, thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.